Morning everyone. In the lecture series today, the lecture third will be delivered on the topic of financial reporting. I am Dr. Vineet Chauhan, Assistant Professor, Padma Singhania University, Udaipur, and we will today discuss about the topic financial reporting. As we know that financial reporting or reporting of the company is being done with the help of the annual reports of the company. So, in the financial reporting part, we will today check it out, the annual report of a company. We will first discuss the points which is being discussed in the annual report, and then thereafter, we will go ahead and we will check the content of the annual report so that we will understand that how the reporting is being made by the company. For this purpose, I have classified the annual reports into two parts, standalone report and consolidated report. So first we start with the help of the reporting, and the reporting head starts with the annual report of a company. If we check out the annual report of any company, the annual report starts with the heading or with the title. The title of annual report will always be given for any report presented by the company. For example, I have one annual report of a company. That annual report is of Reliance Industries, which I have downloaded earlier. This is the annual report of Reliance Industries, and it has a title, Growth is Life. So this is the title of the Reliance Industries annual report 2013 and 2014, and they have also given some words which is related with the title, that is, growth is energy, growth is value, growth is happiness, and finally the growth is life, which is the aim or the title of this annual report. Now thereafter, the dedication is given by the founder or by the main leader of the company. The founder or the leader who has started the company, who have promoted the company, and who have worked from the beginning for the company, or who is the founder member of the company, will provide his own view regarding to the annual report of the company. His views are sometimes taken for the purpose of current report. Sometimes the views are being delivered by the managing director on behalf of the founder member. Thereafter, for each and every company, there is information which is given on the name of the company at a glance. Company at a glance means the major information or the major work done by a company is being displayed here. For example, I have taken this from the Reliance Industries annual report. It says that $67 billion is the annual revenue of this company, which means that it is in Indian currency rupees 4,1,302 crore of Indian rupees is the annual income of the company. So the company at a glance shows that this is the annual income. Not only that, it also includes the other information regarding company, company's product, company's working, company's in other information. If the company is top, then it will shows it to us that company is top in the producing of this particular product. If the company tops in the world, if the company tops in Asia, or if the company tops in the country, then also it is being shown it here that the company is top among this. Not only that, the company will also provide that these are the basic inputs or the basic production or the basic working of the company, and in which company stands at this position. For example, the Reliance has shown that the company is fifth largest producer of the product, eighth largest product manufacturer of the monoethylene glycol. $3.7 is the company's net profit. It is in billion dollar, and ninth largest producer is the company. Company has 1691 retail stores and 80 plus products, with the company is also working in the 4G network, establishing the 4G network, and the company has 12 conventional product, which includes the 9 domestic and 3 international blocks, and the company is largest among the world for these 3 things. Number 1, it is providing the refining complex globally, which is 1.4 MMBPD of crude processing at a single location, so that is the largest in the world. Number 2, the company is producer of polyester fiber and yarn globally, so company is the largest company in this part, and the company is having retailers in India. By the revenue, the Reliance Retail is the largest among the other companies. So this is the basic information which a company will provide it to us for this purpose. Now if we go back and check it out in the company's annual report, we will find that this is the picture of late Shri Dhirubhai Ambani, who is the founder chairman and who has given the guidance regarding the growth, and who has said that growth is life. A few words which he has given it to us is written here. Thereafter, the company will normally provide the index. So this is the index, and this is the last slide which I have shown, Reliance at a glance. This major portion of a company which shows or which provide the highlights of the company's revenue, company's product, company's diversity, company's power, and the major benefit of the company, whether company tops among the others in production or whether the company tops in anything else. So that is being provided here. Now if we go ahead, thereafter the company's key performance indicators are being provided. These key performance indicators are provided in terms of the various proportion, either in the percentage or either in the absolute amount, but these are always presented for the purpose of showing it to the investor, and that is why 4 to 5 years figures are normally being provided under this. If we check it out today, the first, there are total 8 key performance indicators which is being provided by the company, and it starts always with the turnover or the sales of the company. This shows that from the sales of 2,400 crore rupees in 2009-2010, it has increased up to 4,1302 crore rupees in 2013-14, and not only that, from the previous year, from 3,71,119, it has increased up to 4,1302, and it shows that 8.1% is the increase per annum in the sales of the company. So each company will provide the first key performance indicator, that the company's total turnover or sales has increased. The second performance indicator is profit after tax. If we check out profit after tax, the company's revenue and the company's profit, which is after tax, was in 2009-10 was 16,236 crore of Indian rupees, which has increased up to 21,984 crore rupees in 2013-14, and as per the last year figure, 21,003 crore rupees to 21,984 crore rupees, means it has increased, and on year-to-year basis it has increased 4.7% in the previous year. The third performance indicator which is shown by the company is the net worth of the company. Net worth is the amount which is invested in the company from its shareholders and from the capital provider for the long-term capital which is provided by them. If we check it out, the net worth of the company, since the net worth also includes reserve and surplus, so if the company provides reserve and surplus, means the company out of the profit saves some amount for company's growth and not declare it as a dividend, then this amount will be included in the net worth and the total worth of the company will be increased. So if we check out the net worth of the company, in the year 2009-10, the net worth was 1,37,171 crore rupees, and it has increased up to 1,97,074 crore rupees in 2013-14. Not only that, the company's last year's net worth was 1,79,995 crore and has increased up to 1,97,074 crore, which shows that 9.5% is the increase in the company's net worth. The next is market capitalization. In terms of market capitalization, the company has also shown remarkable increase of on an average 20.3% per annum. Now we first check it out, what is the market capitalization? Market capitalization means the company's number of shares which is listed or which is available in the market is multiplied with the per share value on a particular date. This will shows it to us that this is the amount in which the company's total shares will be sold in the market. So when the price of the company's share in the stock market will increase, certainly the market capitalization will increase, and when the price decreases, the market capitalization will also decrease. In case of this, if we check it out, the 2009-10 figure, in the year 2009-10, the company's market capitalization was at a higher stage, and this was at 3,51,320 crore rupees, which has decreased in 2010-11. Again, it has decreased in 2011-12. Later on, from 11-12, it has increased one by one, and 2012-13, it has increased from 2,44,757 to 2,49,802, and in 2013-14, it has increased at the rate of 3,405 from 2,49,802, which means that the market capitalization or the value of company share has been increased at the rate of 20.3% on year-to-year basis. If we check it out, another key performance indicator of the company, another indicator shows, which is earning per share, that what is the amount which the company has earned on per share value of the company's share. So on the basis of per share, the company's earning from 2009-10 has shown a continuous increase, and from 49.7 rupees per share to 68 rupees per share is the highest earning which company has earned on its investment. In terms of the last year figure, the last year company's earning per share was 64.8, and it has increased up to 68. So the earning per share will also be seen, shows it to us that how the company progresses. If the company's profit will increase, certainly the company's earning per share will also be increased. The next one is the book value per share. Book value per share means the value of company's share as per the company's books, and if we check it out, the book value of company's per share has also increased from 2009-10 to 2013-14, and in the year 2013-14 it has shown a 9.4% increase. dividend per share is the next. Dividend per share means the dividend which is declared by the company to its shareholders. It is the part of the company's earning which is to be given to the shareholders. The remaining amount out of the earning per share and the dividend per share difference is treated as the retained earning. So company is also providing the dividend to its shareholders. And if we compare from 2009-10 to 2013-14, we will find it out that the company's dividend policy is stable. It is providing a step-by-step growth and increase in the dividend per share. As in 2009-10 it was just 7 rupees per share, and it has increased up to 9.5 rupees per share in 2013-14. Last year it was 9 rupees and it has shown 5.6% increase. And if we check it out, we will find it out that each year the company has increased either 50 paisa or 1 rupees from 9-10 to 10-11, 1 rupees per share, and thereafter the company is giving each year 0.5 or 50 paisa on per share additional dividend from the last year figure. So which shows a steady growth in the dividend per share of the company. Debt equity ratio is another area of interest for the investor. Investor will always take care that whether the debt equity ratio has increased in the company. If the company will take more loan, more debt, then the debt equity ratio will be increased. This ratio is calculated with the simple formula: the total debt which company has taken divided by total equity. Total equity means the equity shares which are in existence. So we can say that if the debt equity ratio, for example, the current year debt equity ratio is 0.45, which is the highest one after 2009-10, and it shows that, or it will reveal that, in 2013-14 the company has taken loan which is with the backup of equity share capital, and if the equity share capital is rupees 1, the loan which company has taken is 0.45. Normally the debt equity ratio suggested for any company is 0.5 or 0.5:1, which means that for every 1 rupee which is invested by the owner, there must be a backing of debt which is 50% of the equity, so that the functioning of the company will goes on smoothly. And for that purpose, if we check it out, we will find out that from 2010-11 the debt equity ratio has decreased. 11-12 it has decreased, 12-13 it has decreased, but last year the company has taken more loan, or either the company has reduced its capital by taking the capital back with the help of an accounting method called buyback of the share. That is why the company's debt equity ratio has changed. Normally the debt equity ratio of a company will change on the basis of only one thing, and that thing is the company's debt, the amount of debt which is taken by the company. Now thereafter, a letter to shareholders is being written by the company's managing director or the company's chairman. Now here in case of Reliance Industry, this is the picture of Mukesh Bhai Ambani, who is the managing director or chairman of the company, and the chairman writes the letter to the shareholders, which will again highlight the same points which we have discussed. Not only that, it will also provide the future detail, the future information which is to be given to the shareholders. The future plans, future prospect of the company is also included, and it is given as a dialogue with the shareholders. It is open dialogue between the managing director and company's shareholders, and it will address to the shareholders, which starts with "Dear shareholders" or "My company's shareholders. If we check it out in the Reliance company, this was the first or the basic highlight. These are the key performance indicators, and it is given with the help of the chart, and it is always given for a period of 5 years or more. This is the letter for letter by the managing director to the shareholders. This letter says that in the 2013-14, the remarkable growth is being shown by the various economies, and as the global economy has shown the recovery from the drawback, the company has also developed demand of its product in various countries. Thereafter, the chairman has addressed that the company's global demand has increased, the company's production capacity has increased. Not only that, the chairman will also provide information regarding the refining and marketing process, regarding the company's production, regarding the production level, regarding the company's total production, regarding the new plant, new strategy, regarding the consumer business, regarding the production methods, and finally it will be signed by the company's chairman or managing director. Thereafter, the information of company's board of directors are being provided. So the company which I have selected, this company has total 7 person who are in the board of directors. If we start from the beginning, the first one is Shri PMS Prasad, who is the executive director of the company and is the member of Health, Safety and Environment Committee. So this is the picture of Shri PMS Prasad, who is the executive director and the member of the Environmental Health Safety Committee. Number two is Professor Deepak Jain, who is an independent auditor. Number three is Shri Nikhil R. Meswani, who is executive director and member of various committees, which includes Shareholders Committee, Shareholders Relation Committee, Corporate Social Responsibility Committee, Governance Committee and Finance Committee. Next, number four is Dr. Dharamveer Kapoor, who is also an independent director. He is also a member of Human Resource Committee, Nomination and Remuneration Committee, Corporate Social Responsibility and Governance Committee, Health, Safety and Environment Committee. Next to him, at fifth place, Shri Ramniklal H. Ambani, who is the non-executive director and non-independent director, is also with him. He is not the member of any committee because he is not the full-time director, he is independent director. Next to him, at number 6, Shri Man Singh L. Bhakta, who is also an independent director, is also presented here. And the last one, the chairman and the managing director, Shri Mukesh Bhai Ambani, is also in the company's board of director. He is the chairman of the finance committee. So this is the information regarding the board of director is also being provided by the company, because a company cannot be run by only a few people. So there are full-time director, there are independent director and executive and non-executive directors. On the next page we have the next set of directors. So the company will provide detail of the director, not only the detail, the name, it is expressed in terms of the director's capacity, whether director is independent director, executive director, managing director or other any other type of director, and the information that the director is working for which committee, that is also being shown here with the help of the profile of the director. This will be a very short profile. Next, thereafter, the company will provide the company's major benefits, the major area of the company's working, the major part where the company works, and the growth of the company's work within it. So if we check it out, growth is energy, that is the next heading, which shows that company's energy is increasing, company's business of energy sector is increasing. The pictures are being provided, which is the pictures taken for the purpose of showing it to the annual report, and these are the pictures of the company's actual working position. The energy sector's detail is being given, the other sectors detail are also given with this, including retail sector, including telecom sector, including the petrochemical sector, and the major growth, if it is there in a particular sector, it is also being shown by the company in this part. Similarly, if we go to the next part, it shows that the that this company has increased the export by 14.7% in comparison with the last year figure. The company is having 4% of the total market capitalization of the Indian economy, 8% weightage in the Bombay Stock Exchange Sensex. So these are the basic information which is provided by the company for the purpose of company's detail. These are the various details which we check it out from the company. These are the details which is provided for the purpose of investors' point of view and to attract the investor to invest in this company. This is the social investment of the Reliance, which is that company has invested ₹712 crore for CSR expenditure in the last year. Company has touched more than 1 million people with the help of the Reliance Foundation, which is the NGO works under the company, and the company has also provide its information regarding the growth to the society, and company has taken or company has highlighted in 5,500 plus villages and urban location with the help of the Reliance Foundation, which is the NGO works under the company. The benefit which has been given by the company to the people, to the planet, to the product under the corporate social responsibility and sustainable activities, these are also being provided by the company. Thereafter, the sectors of the company for company's revenue, company's expenditures are also included in this part. As the company shows that it is number one in the crude processing facility available in the world, and the plant of the company located at the Jamnagar place. The company is at the 12.7% at Nelson Complexity Index. The crude processing of the company of the last year was 1.4 MMBPD. So that is the strength of the company which is being shown by the company. Since we are in the part of company's overview, so all the information regarding the company's overview is being given here. Like this company has 10 crude grades processed with it. The company is the largest pet coke gasification project to the lower energy coast. The company has 68 MMT crude processing at one place, Jamnagar refinery, and working over 110% of its utilization. Company has 8.1 billion GRM consistently outperforming for regional benchmark. The company's operation from petrochemical is also being shown. Each sector of the company's benefits or the company's sales revenue is being shared with the various shareholders in this part with the help of various pictures and with the help of some information regarding the company's operation. The company is exploring the petroleum product from the sea. So this is the picture, and this is the core strength of this oil well. The company is having at KG-D6, the world largest and most complex deep water gas production facility, and total 13.2 million acres of exploration which company is exploring per annum. This is the picture of the unit which company has established at the sea. The next business is the another business of company, that is the retail. Reliance is also working as Reliance Fresh Mall in various part of the country. So the details are being given with this. These are some of the pictures. The company will also provide the award and recognition which is provided to the company. This company has got the award and recognition in 6 different sectors, like corporate social responsibility, quality, health, safety and environment, reality sector, technological and innovations, and sustainability. So these are also included here. The rest, the company's information is finally highlighted at the end. The company's information is provided with the board of directors, with the board committees and the committee chairman. Not only that, the external agreement with the company, like agreement with the bankers. So the bank in which company is having the account is shown here. The major location of the company's plant with the address is being shown, registered office of the company, and the registrar and transfer agent's detail is also being provided here. The major product is also being shown it here. These are the list of the product which company is producing. The brand name is also being provided, that these are the brand name. Since the company is producing many product, we cannot check it out in detail about each and every product. The company also shows the product flow chart to us. The next major part which is being shown it to us is the financial highlight. But we conclude this lecture here with the help of the company's detail. Now what we understood is that company at the beginning of the annual report provide the detail of company's business, provide the detail of company's shareholders, it provides the detail of company's last 5 years of working, and the company's major business with the highlighted points, that this is the company's major business, and the company's managing director also provide that these are the informations, this is the company's plan, and this is the company's working, the company's current position, and the company's future prospect. So these are the basic things which have been shown by the company. And with this, I conclude the today's lecture. And in the next part, in the next session of this lecture, we will check it out, the financial highlights. Thank you.